That was so funny. Beth said, "You're not doing your class." No, what are you talking about? She said, "It's 12 o'clock." I'm still in the bed, John. But I had a rough night last night. I had to get up for a couple hours because I was like, Beth made the nachos last night, and normally nachos are good, and they were good. Don't get me wrong. But I think, Beth, it was because you didn't have the Piggly Wiggly brand salsa and Piggly Wiggly brand. She had the Walmart brand salsa, I think, and the Walmart brand seasoning, which Piggly Wiggly has the best taco sauce on the planet. So something did not settle with me last night. So I was up. And, what, Beth?
I had the ice cream you ate before dinner.
She said it's probably the ice cream I ate before dinner. Hey, Beth, don't you have something to do? She's multitasking, she says. So anyway, I was still in the bed. I apologize. I am thankful you woke me up. All right, chill out. And Enrico says, nice song. Yeah, I'm telling y'all, I'm just on this Blackhawk kick, right? They're just so good. And they don't have a bad song at all. And I love them. Blackhawk, just really, really, really good. So anyway. So I'm up, man.
I might have to go a couple times.
All right, let's see. That's the great thing about being retired. And normally I teach an Alabama class, so I had to get up on Thursdays and Tuesdays. But we're on, what is it, Ben? We're on fall break. Ta-da! So that's kind of cool. I don't have to teach today. So here we are. All right, so how we doing? Look at this, y'all. The market's up 0.75%. Dang. It's crazy, isn't it? Who would think? It's just really weird. So as we look at our AD, pretty strong, 240. We've seen it stronger, but look, it's kind of been going down, right? And the red dots show, you know, the lows of the day. So now we're popping up there. Then we look at our opening 15 minutes of the day. And it was amazing. I didn't want to come on and just say, did y'all see the prediction I said yesterday? I said, look, if we're going to make a move at the end of the day, what's the move going to be? And it was going to be down. And it's kind of cool how that happened. Because I'm always looking at what's going to catch the falling knife or what's above us, right? So it was kind of cool yesterday that I got it right. I'm a blind squirrel, though, because so many times I'm wrong. But yesterday I was right on. So check this out. The cash open was right at the, you know, the low of the first 15 minutes. That's the first 15 minutes is the gray area there. So 459, what's that? 14 points, I guess. 15 points wide. So, you know, when you look at it now, you go, what's above us? What's above us to stop us? I ain't nothing above us. Look at this. There's no line above us to stop the ascent. That's kind of weird, right? So what's below to catch us, right? If we were to start going down, so we've got this level here, 4572 or 73, which would be support. We've got VWAP that is support. We've got the overnight high that is support. We've got the cash open that is support. We've got this area, which is the low of the opening 15 minutes, which is support. We've got this pivot point that is support. We've got this pivot point that's support. And then we've got overnight low that is support. So when I start looking at this, if I'm, you know, making my assumptions, we got a lot of support below. We got a lot of things that could catch us, right? That falling knife. So it's one of those things today that I go, what do I think would happen in the last 30 minutes today? I think we could go, certainly go up. So there's no resistance above us on any of my lines. So we'll see how the last 30 minutes kind of play out, but this is really, really kind of bullish, right? Really, really bullish looking. So we look at volume. Well, we didn't even talk about hourly mid-band. Here's the hourly mid-band too that's down below to catch us. So all kind of stuff to catch us down here. And this is really, really, really bullish. All right, so now let's go and let's look at our volume profile. And I posted it yesterday. It's just amazing how it works, isn't it? So yesterday, look at this. I mean, it just, you know, we know that price popped up here. We know that this is overbought. Look at this, where the interaction is with that line. Then it comes back into the fair value point. And then what does it do? It goes back up and it's just overbought again. So here we are, overbought above the 20, 50, and 200 period moving averages. So this is a little bit of resistance, right? This little value area high of volume profile. So over the coming days, what am I? Well, I would probably be neutral to bearish and expecting a pullback to the 45.27 area, because it really, it'll probably fill up some of these areas here. Now, here's the thing too. When you see this one almost as big as this one, then if we spend a lot of time up here, this is just going to get longer and longer and longer and longer and longer, right? So the longer that this line gets and more volume is traded here, the more likely that our point of control on volume is likely to move up. So we'll see. You know, I always laugh because, you know, on these assumptions that I have about the market, it's funny. It's like, okay, it's probably going to go here, but if it doesn't go here, it's going to go here. Okay, genius, Bobby Genius, you know exactly where the market's going. No, I got no idea. But if looking at this, I would say that I'm neutral to bearish over the coming, you know, 10 days. That's just what I'm saying. That's a big, 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 big update. All right. But then we got to go to our other little thing that helps us, and that's the skew driver. So the skew driver, I like to see this turn to 520 somewhere. We're looking at a 20-point SPX spread that's trading for 520. We want to know how many points away it is from the money. So if this will turn to 520 at any time soon. 515 is 43 away. And it's just changing. It's getting the data from Thinkorswim. 510, still 510. Come on, 35, 43 going once. 43 going twice. 515, there it is. It's still 43, right? All right, so let's do that. Let's put that in, 43. That's interesting. And yesterday was 42. So today is 43. What does that mean, Bob? Not exactly sure. Let's see. 10, 28, 21. Aha. Look at there. That's interesting, isn't it? Because the farther away this goes, the more bullish that we are. And it's strange on the day that the market is so bullish that the skew has increased. Aha. So I wonder what that's telling me about the VIX. Let's see that. Let's see what the VIX is doing. I always tell you, we never check it. None of us, do we? Let's go over here. Gosh, we're at $766 over here. Praise the Lord Jesus. All right, so let's see what VIX is doing. Why do I have a sneaky suspicion that the VIX might be, I don't want to say it, I don't want to say that it's up, but listen to us now. That's interesting. VIX is down, but the skew has increased a little bit from yesterday. Very interesting. Very interesting. What does that mean? Not exactly sure. Not exactly sure. So VIX is down. Okay. Let me look at VIX. Let's look at this. So on a great up day like this, y'all, if you don't have, you know, if you don't have your calendar spreads on, it's a great day to do it. All right. VIX is down. Market's up. So you could easily put on a calendar spread. Let's see if I got a calendar spread over here at all. ES, 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 no. So let's see, I've got big positive delta over here. That's why I'm up 753. I got a little bit of negative theta, and I got a little bit of positive theta. Well, we've got to fix that, right? We got to fix that. So why don't we do a little calendar trade and just show y'all that in the SPY. SPY, where I normally do my calendars. Looks like I got plenty of options buying power in this little account. Sorry, yeah, I'm trying to battle thinking I'm going to get sick again. I'm sitting there thinking, oh, I kind of feel sick. I had to shut off the computer real quick. Like y'all know, I'm really sick. But we're going to press through. Last thing you want me to do is start hurling here on the computer. All right. So what do I do with a calendar spread? So remember, it's part of our plan, right? We're not chasing new shiny stuff. I'm over it. We got our plan. So a calendar trade is I'll go out about 60 days. So 64 days. I will buy the option that is right at a 40% chance of being in the money. Why that? That's how Tom Shoshnoff has best said, taught me how to do this. Okay. So I'm going to buy the 447. Now, this is interesting because I'll bet you I'm going to have to do the 445, but we'll see. We're going to try the 447, see if I can find one. So I'm going to buy the 447. Then I'm going to go down to about 30 days. So if I'm at 64, I'm going to go to 34. Okay. Then I'm going to sell the 447. Yeah, and there's no 447. So I got to do the 445. Let's do the 445. 445. All right. Now you could do this, right? Because this would be not a calendar, but this would be a, if I did the 445 and 447, what would that be? That would be a diagonal. Let's see what that would look like. Analysis. Make sure we got it looking what it looks like. Theo's on. Yeah, that kind of looks good, right? So look at that. Isn't that cool? So if we move this one to the 445, you can play with these things too, right? 445, that's a calendar, okay? So you see the difference. That was gonna cost me 379. Well, what if you want this to be more one way or the other? You can move this thing, look at that. Check that out. How about that? It's a calendar, it's a diagonal. Look at that. Can't lose the downside. We created a brand new trade. Of course, it's a lot more expensive too, though, right? Just kind of cool to play with it. But I just like doing a normal calendar. 445. There we go. What if you wanted to look this way? Check that out. That doesn't look good at all, does it? I'm seeing a lot of red. Moving it this way, man, we got something great. Look at this. Ta-da! How can you lose? You're going to pay $2,400 and something dollars, right? For that trade. So this is all I need. It's a 445, just a regular old calendar. Isn't that cool? So here's where the price is. And, you know, you got a nice little profit hump, a little bit to the downside, which is kind of cool. There. That's what I want. So a little calendar. All right. So that gives me negative deltas, which is not bad because I got 237 positive, right? And it's going to give me positive theta, which I desperately need in this account, right? And what about the Vega? Well, let's see what happens to Vega. It's negative 23. So let's wrap this for $379. Just put us a little calendar in. Come here, little baby. Come here, little pumpkin. Nothing. Jack, squat, crap, nothing. That's okay. I'm about to pay a little bit more for it. Working. Or I feel better all of a sudden. It's like all of a sudden I was feeling come over me again. Come on, I'm going to get filled. Feel me, baby. Be careful who you sell that to, especially if there's a restraining order against you. Feel me, baby. Here we go. Come on. Feel me now. Dang it. This is embarrassing. Maybe to that off. Come on, baby. Here we go. Ta-da! That took my Vega from negative 23 to zero. We are the champions, my friends. Took my delta down a little bit and gave me more theta. See how sweet that is? And Vegas where you get killed, y'all, on a down move. You ever want to get killed on a down move? It's Vegas that'll kill you. So now we're looking pretty good, right? I like it. I like it a lot. And let me see. I wanted to show y'all this, too. Hold on a second. Now that sick feeling's coming back over me again. It's like, leave me alone. Let's see. What do we want to do? I had something I've got to do. Hold on. I know y'all think I'm a raging alcoholic. I promise I'm not. I'm just having a rough day. What am I trying to do? Hold on. I want to show y'all something. What was I going to show y'all? Oh, here. Tasty works. PhD works. I'll spell it. I know I'm having a terrible day. Tasty Works. Never click on the ad things because that gives Google money. And I need to start going to DuckDuckGo anyway. Those commie bastards. At let's see if I can show you all this trading platform. I don't go to this as often as I should. It's kind of cool, though, right? Yeah. Where's it at? Portfolio. Here we go. Ta-da! I like looking at this little thing right here, huh? So you can see that who cares what Fascia or whatever his name's doing. So let's see. Oh, it looks a little bigger. Let's see. There. Here we are. Look, this is my portfolio. Ta-da! It looks really bullish, right? I make a lot of money. I lose a little money here and then start losing big money there. Of course, this doesn't take into account that I have black swan hedges, but I don't have as many black swan hedges over here as I should. But I kind of like looking at this, right? It tells you that my total probability of profit is 68%. So I kind of like that. What's the new dashboard look like? Look at that. Isn't that cool? I need to look at that more often. All right, but I didn't like a couple things here. Let's see what my positions in this one are. Do I have enough black swan hedges? No, I don't. I've only got one. Well, what is this? Well, I got something else here. Oh, okay, I got something else here. I got a negative three and a five, so that's one. And then I've got a five there, negative three, negative five, so I probably need to start building that up at some point. So it seems like I put on one yesterday, so that's good. That's good. I need to build that more. The problem is I don't have a way to do the great analysis like I do on my thinkorswim trade. So I almost feel naked in this one, and I need to do the same exact things. But, man, this is rocking, right? Our new little program is just rocking, just doing well. All right. Sell two shares. Oh, my gosh, I've got a trigger. How cool is this, y'all? I love it. I sold two shares yesterday, and now it's telling me to sell two more shares. Well, let's do it. So what is it going for today? Man, I'm not used to feeling bad. I normally always feel good. Today, I'm like, TQs are going for, I'm going to sell at 152.49. So let's sell two shares. 152.49. TQs, 152.49. This is a cash machine, y'all, and it's cool. The ATM is saying, hey, Bob, sell two shares. So I'm going to sell. And you're saying, why does this not match that? Because I have to pay for data over here, and I'm not going to do it. I'm too cheap. I'm a cheap SOB. So what I said is 152.55. I like it a lot. So we're going to sell two shares, just like the little machine says, my ATM machine, 152.55. What it was? 152.55. This thing is run away. Let's see if I can get filled on my two shares. Ta-da! There I am. Cool. So isn't that cool? We convert shares to cash because that's what the little deal thing does. Oh, look at that. So we got filled at 152.55. All right, let's go put it in our spreedsheet. 152.55. So we go to AIM activity. Look, we sold two yesterday. 152.55. Did that in the year of our Lord, 10/28/21. Negative two. Well, I hope I ain't got the corona. Oh, Lord, help us all. All right. So then you got to say, is this new capital rebalancing or new underlying? The answer is no. It's very important that you know what to do here. Yes or no, right? It's not. I mean, it's just it's one of our signals. So if we get a signal, it's a no. Okay. So there we go. So then we'll go back over the dashboard and it should say, ta-da, look at you, Bob. Now, here's where you're going to get sick though, right? I started this on, what did I start this? On the 15th at 45, 437. 45,437. Okay. And let's put a minus on that. So this thing today says that I have made $4,423.54 in 13 days. But that's not right because I've underperformed that. This is just telling you what I've made if on my shares, right? On my shares of TMF and TQQ, I'm up $4,400. But I'm not that up because why? We've got options trades and we've got hedges against that that's slowing it down. And I've sold a put against it. But we're doing really good, though, still. So we're up. So from 45,437, we are at 48,126. Well, we'll leave it there. So we've made 2,666 divided by, what do we start with? 45,437. Just kind of cool to see how much you've done, right? We're at 5.6% 6%, y'all, in 13 days. That ain't bad at all. I like that. All right. So, never count our chickens before it hatches, and I'm sure the whole system will collapse at some point. But so far, so good. It's doing exactly what we think this thing should do. And the ATM machine is doing exactly what it should do. It's converting shares to cash as this goes up. So, very interesting. All right, so let's go see how our stuff is doing today. So, we are down $171. Oh, my gosh. It's over. It's come to an end. All right, so what is, let's see, our TQs are doing good as always. Our micros are doing good as always. Our VIX hedge is down. Our SPY calendars are down. My TMF is down. That's never down. Our ES is down. And that's our hedges, right? And our SPX trade is down. Good Lord. Why did I put that SPX trade on? So let's see if our deltas are okay. So I told you I'm neutral to bearish. Well, that's fine. Negative 49 deltas. Make sure there's 5 beta weighted. And I've got nice positive theta. And I've got great, great, great vega. So, you know, if you're reaching the pain max point on this XPX trade, I could close it if I wanted to. Take the loss. You know, I don't know if I need to or not, but you could. Certainly could. Take the loss. All right. Lose the money, but I'm kind of bearish, so I think I'm going to leave that on. I like what it's giving me. It's giving me negative 85 delta, so if I close that, I would be at positive 34 delta. Everybody see that? And it's giving me positive theta, and I love the vega that it's giving me. All right, so what should I do today in this account? What should I do? What could I do? Let's make sure we know what to do, and I'll bombard you with this all the time. Right? Let's get our little drawing stuff. I like drawing. I got all these little tools we need to draw. There's our all right. So let's think. It's an update. Market's up. So we've got to know what we got to do. Market's up. All right. Number one. Do you have all your VIX hedges in? VIX hedges mean going out 120 days. We do this every 30 days. And multiplying your net lick times 0.0025. And that'll tell you the amount of dollars you can spend on VIX calls. So then you go out 120 days and you find the 10 delta call and you buy enough to kind of approximate that amount of money. Right? That sick feeling's coming to me again. I'm like, I think I'll roll back in the bed after we get finished with this. Try to get better. All right, so that's one thing we do on the up. So especially we'll do this if the VIX is down on the day. And the VIX is down today. So it's a good day to put that on if you don't have it. Okay, if you don't have it, I've already got it, so I don't have to do that. What's the second thing that we do? We can do calendars. And I just showed you how to do that. What do we do calendars on? Well, you can do calendar on anything. You can do it on the ES, micros, whatever. I like doing them on SPY. Now, since we're in the TQs, you could actually do a calendar just like we did it on the Qs as well. Okay, great day. Now, so if you've got the TQs in your thing and you haven't done the covered call, remember, on an up day is a great day to sell your calls. You say, Bobby, you shouldn't have sold any calls. I know. Because look, I'm up 373 on TQs today, but look what I'd be up if I weren't selling calls against it. Because I'm losing $725 on my calls today. Oh my gosh, you moron. Yeah, but look, I'm fine with that. I'm more than fine with that because I'm still up $380. Isn't that cool? I love it. I just love this little plan. May we never trade another one. Just keep this one going. All right. But we hadn't seen the 20% drop yet. We'll see what happens during that time. So you could sell calls, right? So we kind of know. Now, if you need extra protection in your account, you can buy an entire tranche of the Black Swan Hedge, of -3. Plus 5 in ES. That's what we do. That's the game plan. This is what we do on the updates. Now, am I forgetting something? Probably not. So I'm not even talk about down days today because it's an update. So this is what we do. So if you don't have your VIX hedge in, you can put it in. If you need positive Vega, if you need positive Theta, and you need a little bit of short Delta, you can put a calendar in. Or you can sell calls on your shares, right? And make that a covered call. If you don't have a covered call yet, I know you're looking at mine going, I don't want to do that, man. This thing's to the moon. I got you. But one day it won't be. Or you can do an entire Black Swan hedge if you need it. Now, do you need it? Well, let's see if we need it. Okay? Let's just see if we need it. So we go to the Analyze tab. I always do this with SPY or the E-minis, kind of look what our account looks like. So then I go E-minis, and then I go single symbol. I'm going to hide simulation. So it just shows me my stuff that we actually have in here. Let's see. Make sure we got everything checked. Now let's see how we look. So our price slices, nothing magic here. I do 7 price slices, just like I like looking at it. So it says if you had a 20% down move, you're going to be up $16,000. Ta-da! Only problem is, let me go today. You're going to be up $9,000. Okay? But this doesn't take into effect volatility. So we go up here and we go, let's see what the vol steps would be. 4. And I change this to 15%. And then we're going to see how we're going to do on 20% down crash. So if I'm down 20% crash, I'm going to be up, $132. Sorry, $132,000. I like it. So now you're going to look at your whole portfolio. So instead of going single symbol, you're going to go portfolio by weighted to make sure that we're going to be firing in a down move. So let's see that. So now you're going to be up 12,000 to 49,000. I like it. I like it a lot. Okay. I like it a lot. So, you know, is there a need for me to put a Black Swan hedge in today? No. But if I wanted to, I could. Now let's see our groups. Let's just look at our groups. See how my groups are doing. All right, Black Swan hedges, calendar, we know are down. Let's see if there's anything else I want to look at that I need to make any changes on. I love the 1-1-1 trades. If I could only get some more down days to put some of these on, it's rare that we get a down day. 1-1-18, 1-1-1-19. I mean, is there a better, you know, that one's kind of bookie, right? Because we don't have all the stuff in there, but still. 1-1-16, $154. I just love those. 1-1-20th, and a little bit. What's wrong with that one? I'm gonna fire you. My covered calls. What a dope head I am. Look at me. Fat black glass ass wearing bastard. All right, so I'm down $705 there. I'm down $1,200 on my calls. Oh, behave. Unbelievable. What's wrong with me? We'll worry with those tomorrow, though, right? 111.88. Look up there, $167. That's the money shot right there, baby. These things, the bonds, still at $520 down. And, you know, we've got the bonds in the program, too, right? So AIM can give us triggers to buy or sell that as well as it fails or goes up. So let's see, 111.14. It's up $156. Look at that. Quantity, 22 days on that. Nothing to do there. My TQ Empire. If only I were just running the TQ. Look at there, y'all. That's you know, that's incredible. Y'all believe that? Since October the 15th, I mean, that is 13 days. This thing is up $4,400. Now, we got to make sure. I don't want y'all thinking, oh, my gosh, we have found Nirvana. Keep in mind, the day's going to come when you're going to see that down $4,000. Do you have the stomach? You're going to see it. I'm just, you know, I'm preparing you for it. The day's going to, when that's going to be down big. So just, we like it when it's up. Now, the cool thing is that our little cash machine, our little ATM has already converted 4 shares to cash though, right? So the farther this thing goes up, the more of these little signals we're going to get to take some off, Bobby. So,
hey, Bobby.
Yeah.
Since you're selling calls against a long stock position in the AIM, if you suspect the down move or see one begin, it seems to me that if you do a version of a collar and sell and buy some puts, you might be able to mitigate some of that down move loss.
Yeah, I think you're right. And so that's why that's a great point. So, you know, that's why, Ken, I think it's good for us to come in and kind of form our assumptions, right? So say I wanted to protect this. Ken's exactly right. I've got calls that I've already sold about it. So I can go and I could buy, like if I thought it was going to be a big down move tomorrow, then I could buy puts, you know, and I'd probably not buy them in the, you know, technically a collar should be in the same expiration, but I'd probably buy puts another week out and, you know, roll my calls tomorrow so that I would roll into a collar. But he's exactly right. So, you know, when you have these assumptions and you're like, man, I need to protect this profit that we got, he's exactly right. The way to do that is through a collar. And that's why we added it to the program. It's great, right? Because we do have market assumptions. So, you know, if the skew driver was at 15 today, then I would go, man, we're getting ready, man. We're going to, you know, I would protect that somewhat. I certainly would. And that's a great point. It's powerful.
And another part of that is your program that covers the AIM doesn't factor in
exactly
short calls.
Exactly. It does.
So it's going to tell you to buy and sell stock as the conditions arise. Mm-hmm. So you could have a massive down day. And with your protective puts, you can't recover at all. It's just too costly. But you can recover a portion of that. And then you still have the orders come in to buy more long stock. And then you kind of can have your cake and eat it too. You know, the market's going to take a bite out, but it's not going to take a whole slice.
Exactly. Right. So we know how to do things. And I think that's why. And I'll do the quote unquote, the experts say we can't hold this long term, right? And that's why we said the whole hold my yoo-hoo and y'all watch this. I think you and I, Ken, and all of our group here, we've got the tools necessary to help us to mitigate losses in those things. You know, now, let's say that Rod, he's got, you know, his 401k, so he can't do that necessarily. Do some of the stuff that we're doing with options in there, but certainly I would, if you're doing this in a 401k, you know, make sure you've got a side account somewhere where you're running your hedges and doing your different things to kind of offset what may be happening in your 401k. But even if you don't have that, you know, if you've got a 20 year horizon, I think you're going to be fine. Just let the AIM algorithm run. Take you, you know, convert. It's an ATM machine, y'all. This is exactly what we built. It's an ATM machine. It tells you to when to take profits, when to buy more. And then if you can mitigate those losses with collars and other things that we have, it's incredible. Yeah, I'm looking here now going, why am I selling calls? My God, I'd be up, you know. And maybe I need to take that into consideration with the calls, not just necessarily have them on at all times. You know, maybe I need to be looking at that and going, you know, what's my market assumption? Market assumption first, then decide if the calls are necessary. But at this point, I'm in them. I could close them, take that big loss of $1,100 or whatever it is. But, you know, I still like the way this is performing, even with the calls. So we'll see. But we got options. We'll make that joke, right? We got options. A lot of things we can do. This one expires tomorrow. Check that out. So, you know, you could take that risk off the table, but chances are it's going to expire tomorrow. And that short one will expire worthless. What does that look like? Let's see what that looks like. Let's see our analyze on our 111 trade. So let's go MES. Which one was that? 11. So let's go to the one expiration. So all groups? No, we'll go 111. It's one of these. I think I got 2 1111, so I gotta make sure. Let's see what the little baby looks like. Look at this shot. Is that pretty or what? I mean, why would you close it? Look at this. I'm going to make the maximum profit probably tomorrow that to the upside, which is 99 cents. Isn't that $99? Look at that. Isn't that great? So I'm like, oh man, Bob, this has got one day left on it, right? Is this more than one day left? I think so. Let's see. If I flip this up, it should go, well, I'm not sure if that's it or not. Yeah, that is. That's it. So check it out. I want this one to go down. You know, you're sitting there going, well, Bobby, I closed that short put there. Really? That's at 38.51. You think we're going to 38.51 is my break-even tomorrow? Or to 39.64, which is the daily break-even today, right? Tomorrow it'll be here. Look at that, y'all. I want it to come in here. Look at that. I want it to come down. That is a strong trade. I just loving these 111. Now, I did a little bit of poo-pooing the other day on the bear trap or whatever. It's not that it's a bad trade. I don't need it. I don't need it. I don't need to complicate my little program further. I don't need to go, oh man, let's do the bear traps too. So I don't need a bear trap. This is all I need right here. And so you get several of these things. Let's see. Let's do single symbol, show what it all looks like. This is going to be cool, y'all. What's this? Then we'll go to all groups. So we'll go all groups. So this is my total. Well, it's only one expiration. We got 4 expirations. So we can see 4 of them. Expiration 4. Let's see what this looks like. Look at this, y'all. Look what we got here. Isn't that cool? Isn't that wild? So we got a little profit hump. Look at this. If the market keeps going up, all my 111 trades are going to make me 2,200 and blah, 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 blah. We want it to stay right here, right? But watch what happens if we go down. You know, you've got all of these up here, look, that are kicking up and giving you all kind of, you know, $3,198, right? So we go down. What is that? That's a 10% move. Yeah, 10% move down. So you're losing on some of those others or whatever, but look at that overall. 3,198 that we'd be up on this one. Isn't that cool? So we're just building a little camel over here, building a little hump to the downside. This is our grind down. This is our grind down trade. So I think we thought of everything. So we've got hedges that will hedge, you know, 20 to 30 or 50% down move in the market. Yeah, we got it. Black Swan hedge, fixed hedge. What about if we grind down? We got 111s. And every time the market's down, we put on another one. We just keep laying these things in here. Why? We're building this great, humongous profit if we go up. We got profit if we go down. All the way. Look at there. December 18th, we're up $3,198. 12-1, we're up $5,000. 11:20, we're at $5,800. That's what you do. We're building a camel here. We've got a big old hump here, one hump camel. Isn't that great? So we know, and then, y'all, we don't worry if the market goes up. We don't even worry if the market stays the same. You know, these things are going to make us an inordinate amount of money, you know, considering the size of the account and what we've got on. I mean, it's just a great little plan. You know, I'm trying to poke holes in it. I'm trying to say, where is it weak? See if we need to plug up some holes. But for the most part, we got some cool, cool stuff going on. Yeah, well, problem is, some of y'all, I hate to say it, y'all want the, let's put it that way. I hate to say it, but here's what we do. And I do it too, so I'm not just fussing on y'all. We got the SOS. Y'all know what it is. We got the shiny object syndrome. Shiny got an EY in it, or is it just this? Okay, expression. Shiny object syndrome. Not sure how to spell syndrome. Don't know what it, that's it. This ain't shiny enough. Bob being up six, what were we up? What's my count say? We're up 6% on the account in 13 days. That ain't shiny enough, Bobby. It's just not shiny. So we're that up on, you know, I hate doing this. Because some people fuss at me. That's not how you do it. So we're that up in 13 days. So we'll divide that by 13. So what would this be if you annualized it so far? 65. Right? So 165% it would not be good enough for you. Now I know it's not going to do that, right? But hey, what if we do a third of that? What's a third of that? 350 something? Would you be happy there? So don't be chasing shiny objects. Let's just stop. Let's stop it. I'm talking to myself. So when y'all say we start bringing in new stuff, and I shouldn't bring in new stuff until February. That's the next beach vacation. That's when I sit there, hold hands with Beth, and we look off into the sunset, and she's thinking about, oh, Bob's thinking about us and the kids walking down the beach, and I'm thinking of charge. And she doesn't even know it. It's charge in my head. That's when we'll come up with the next. If I don't go to the beach in December, which is a chance I will. May leave Beth and the kids here. Oh, yeah. Y'all believe that, right? All right. Questions, comments. Yeah, but this one, look, this account here. Do I even have covered calls over here? Oh, my gosh. No wonder this one's doing so good. I don't have the covered calls, do I? Yes. Look, I don't even have them. Isn't that cool? No wonder this one's doing good. Up $740. So, yeah, Ken, I think we're, you know, they're optional. You want to put them on. Now, today might be a good day to put them on because what's our assumption? Our assumption is, now what's this? I'm going to put TQs here. And y'all going to freak out a little bit, okay, when I do this watch. Because I freaked out yesterday. I go, oh, my gosh. Look how great our chart is here. What's this? Come on, baby. Come on, darling. Hey, while that's loading, remember what we're supposed to do, though? You know, you stay in the TQs as long as we look at SPY, as long as we're above the 200 moving average. I need to bring that up a little more. Now, if this ever comes down out of this thing here, we might want to say, uh-oh, you know, if we get down below the 200 daily simple moving average, then it may be a chance to switch to bonds and out of TQs. So we got, you know, and the problem is if I switched out, guess what I'm going to do, though? I'm not going to tell my aim that we've got out. I think I'm going to let my aim still run and let it go. Hey, Bob, you need to be buying more shares and just keep up with that too. I don't know. So we got a lot of options. Let's go back to our little chart here. Watch this. I was flipping out over this last night. I go, oh my gosh, look at this. Look at this. This nailed it, Bob. Look at this. And it said, hey, there's going to be a pullback because this is overbought. And it did. The only problem is, look, this one is July for August. Isn't that cool? I need to redraw it. Some of y'all don't know how to do the big green monster. Let's do one, if I can remember how to do it. So let's go to the TQs. Let's see what that looks like. All right, so I got to go to my clean chart. And I probably need to sell this. I don't need to sell nothing. I need to share this with y'all. sell this. Yeah, I need to share this with y'all in the plane. Hold on a second. So let's go T. And let me share this chart with you. This is how I did the Big Green Monster. Share grid. Okay, we'll go into our little Zoom chat. Control V. So if y'all copy that, y'all can open it up in FocusWall. Right, where am I at? Unbelievable, Bob. What is wrong with you? Here we go. So you make sure this is on the daily, 3 month, 1 day. That's right, I think. All right, so here's what we do. So this is the month of October. So you take September. We're about ready to draw another one. Let's see how close this is. So we're going to use September to project for October. All right, so let's draw this thing. Now, keep in mind that I'm not feeling well, a little under the weather, best tried to poison me or something. I've always told her, honey, listen, if you ever want to leave me, don't kill me, right? I will, you know, hey, I'll wish you well. I'll help you pack. I'll miss you. But just don't poison me. Don't kill me. Because I think she's probably, if she had to, she's capable of it. So not saying that she's doing it, but you know, she certainly could. All right, so I draw it from the bottom to the top. Then I want to make sure I got it exactly right. So here's what I do. I'll right click. Did y'all ever watch the movie Flowers in the Attic? Where that woman was giving her little grandkids, she'd lock them in the attic, and she'd give them like poisonous cookies. What the crap? Now, make sure, you know, you got your cursor on this, on the month that you want, because you want to know what the high and the low is for that month. So if I'm over here, that's giving me the wrong high and low, right? Got to be over here on September. So the high for September is 152.88. And then over here, the low is 124.08. Because I swear y'all are going to go, what the crap is this? For those of y'all are new, trust me. Just trust me. As long as I know how to do it. All right, so there we go. Isn't that pretty? All right, so now you got to change this thingy to this. Now, the problem is, you know, these aren't regular field levels. So if you're using fields, it's different. You got to change your fields. Let me just show you that. You got to change your fields. And your fields just got to be -1, -0.8. Y'all need to screenshot this. Everybody, I'm going to give you a chance to screenshot it. This is what your fields got to be. -1, -8, -5. And then I make this my default, right? Y'all screenshot it. So then we got to go to our extension tools and you got to change those too. But I'll show y'all how to do that. And let's see if I remember what to do here. So I've drawn over here. Oh, here we go. So I got to draw this to here, right? I draw my 50% line to the middle of this and then I go up to zero. God, I think that's right. And I apologize because I am a bit out of it. So I start at the 50% line. And I go up to the middle there. I get right in the middle. And then I go up to the zero line here. Everybody see that? This one gets tricky. All right. Here's what you're going to say. Oh, Bob, you've missed it, man. What the devil's wrong with you? So now I got to move some stuff. So what I got to do is I got to move the zero up to the 200. Okay, everybody with me? So I'm going to go right click here and I'm going to activate. Zero up to the 200. Uh-oh, did I do it right? Yeah. Did I do it right? Undo add Fibonacci extension. And just let me do it fast. This is
While you're doing that, Bobby,
Matt, what happened to you? What happened to Matt? Matt, I don't hear you anymore.
Oh, sorry. I must have muted it again.
You muted yourself.
I was listening to Corey this morning,
mm-hmm.
and they were playing an Earnings Butterfly on Apple.
Huh?
Just thought I'd throw that out there.
That's cool.
If anybody wanted to gamble on it.
What was he using to do the... Corey was doing a butterfly on Apple? Interesting.
I believe so. There's so many of them.
Oh, yeah.
But they were doing the expected move, the $4 expected move.
Oh, cool. Now, y'all, that's one of those things. If y'all want to do earnings trades, y'all do them. I found that it was a losing proposition for me. I remember the first one I did was on IBM. I thought, man, I know my stuff. I found out I didn't learn nothing. Oh, I can remember I was so happy when I found out about credit spreads. I was like, all you got to do is sell credit spreads. Move that up to 200.
When you hear those words, all you got to do, you should run and don't look back.
Yeah, I thought, man, I've got it now. I am the stuff. And I remember I just lost. I blew out my account doing credit spreads, one third the width of the strike. I thought I was God's gift, y'all. So you move that little 100 right there. I think I'm right on this. Again, my head's kind of foggy today. Y'all probably up. Just give me a... There. Ta-da! Now we're done. So now let's see what this looks like. So then I always change it green. I call it the big green monster. Hey, have you been watching Blake in there? Is Blake still with the Theo trade? Matt? Unmute yourself, Matt. Set color, we'll call this green. Now let's see what this looks like. So now we got something that might can help us. So now let's go back to volume profile. Let's see what this looks like. Unbelievable. Now, all this great stuff. Let's change it to TQ. Yeah, and see, Matt bringing that in there, and I'm like, get thee behind me, Satan. That's what I'm thinking. Because now I'm like, now I want to look at Apple. Right, let's see what we got here. Look at this. Right, we got the TQ.
No, I'm not doing it.
You're not doing it, you just bring it to us. I got you.
Yeah.
That's fine. All right, so if
Apple is up like $3 today, $2.
And two,
$3.35.
You know, if y'all want to wheel stuff that you want to own anyway, right, what would you do on Apple? So if I was going to do an earnings trade, then on Apple, and I wanted to own the stonk, as they say on Wall Street. Oh, by the way. So I joined a Reddit group called Professors, right? And all they do is get on there and just bitch about their jobs, and they bitch about their students. And that's all they do all day long. So listen to this, y'all. So they get on there and they're like, it just really pisses me off when I see my students driving better cars than I do. And they've got their BMWs and their Lexus. And here I've got this, and they're so entitled, and they're so this, and they're so that. And all I did is get on there and say, listen, you people are pathetic and miserable. I said, by the way, I said, I want my students to be successful. I said, I try to teach them how to be successful. And I said, a couple of y'all need to take my investments class. I got kicked out. I didn't get kicked out. I got muted for 10 days. I got blocked for 10 days. I've got a negative 24 rating. You know how you upvote or negative vote? Those stupid unbelievable professors in there, libs, you know, who love socialism and communism and, you know, God, they probably love Hitler, are downvoting me by 24 because I told them to get a life and, you know, that'll be getting their students to be successful rather than being envious. And I simply said, envy is a dangerous, dangerous, dangerous emotion. When you're looking at the Joneses and going, I want to do better than that. Unbelievable. So I got kicked out for 10 days. I cannot comment. So they can still comment about what a horse's arse I am. Let's see what that old gal said about me. Oh, they pissed me off. Hold on a second. Beth says, why do you get in there and watch that? Because it gets my blood pressure full. Listen to what they said about me. Hold on a second. Where's Red at? Yeah, watch this. Here's what they said about me. Stupid idiots. Oh, I got an upvote on something. Unbelievable. Hold on a second. Oh, here it is. Some snooty booty by the name of Cesarine, who is a graduate teaching assistant in English, says, you seem to spend an inordinate amount of time shitposting and whining on a sub for a profession you aren't a part of. Well, hell, I am a part of. You call it University of Alabama, chopped liver? I would highly recommend getting a life. Let me tell you something, you black glass ass wearing bitch. I got a life. Sorry, y'all, I should have said that. I'm a little sick today. I'm under the weather. All right, so what are we looking at here on the TQs, y'all? Look at there. We're at the volume area high. We would expect this to be an area of resistance, right? Which it looks like it was here, right? And it's kind of playing around there now. So that's an area of resistance. Wouldn't surprise us to see a pullback to this area, right? To fill in some of these gaps, and then maybe even go back to the point of control. But with that said, we are fairly priced. Everybody sees this? We're fairly priced. And could also see a move up to the 50% line before ultimately going to the next point here would be around 168 right there. Isn't that cool? That's just kind of, if you want to look at that, I'd probably, now this would look exactly the same if we did this on the Qs. So there's really no need to either do it on the Qs or this. It should be identical for the Qs. It's just this one moves, you know, three times as much. Right. I literally laughed out loud on that, Bobby, in the office. Yeah. But listen, I am a troublemaker, and y'all know that. If y'all search Sweet Bobby, I get into fights online with all these people, you know, who call me this name and that name, and they hate me, and, you know, that's fine. I got no problem. I am a kind of crusty old geezer, you know, set in my ways. I just don't like all these people that say, you know, envy. Envy. I want my kids to drive a better car than I did. I got a 2011 Nissan Rogue paid for, given to me by my mama. Oh, Bobby, you didn't buy your car? No, my mama gave it to me. You know why? Because every time she gets a new car, I go with her and I get a good deal. Now, let me tell y'all this. I'm going to tell y'all the secret of getting a new car. Beth, should I tell them? She don't care. All right, listen, first of all, don't be financing your new cars and all that kind of stuff. If you want to get a new car like my mama does, here's what you do. You call the 15 closest dealerships to you that has the kind of car you want. And as soon as they pick up the thing, they'll say, yeah, Pioneer Ford, how can I help you? Yes, my name is Bobby. I want to speak to your salesperson that's having a miserable month, that is about to die of starvation, and they ain't got no money to their name, and they're probably going to quit next week. I said, that's the person I need to talk to. And I said, listen, I know you're going to give me the person that's next on the list, right? No, don't give me the one on the list. I said, listen, I'm going to buy a car. We're going to make somebody's day. And so they're kind of impressed by that. So they'll get you the one that's just the most horrible salesperson on the planet, right? That's about to quit. They just started 3 months ago and they hadn't sold a single car. So you get that person on the phone. You say, hey, I'm Bobby. I said, do you want to sell a car? Well, yeah, I want to sell a car. Well, here's what you do. I said, I need you to be quiet because I'm going to tell you specific instructions. If you do not abide by the specific instructions, you will lose this deal. Do you understand? Yes, sir. So they think I'm in control. There's none of this. I'm going to see the manager. Let me check with this. And then here's what you say. Okay, I need you. And I used to do it by fax. Nah, I don't do fax anymore. I do by email. I said, here's what I want you to do. Here's the car I want. I want you to send me your drive out price No extra taxes, tags, titles, this, that. I said, drive out price on that car. What, Beth? Yeah. I said, give me that price. I said, I want it today. I said, here's the problem. I'm also going to go to some of your competitors, and I'm going to ask them for the best price, okay? If you are not the successful bidder, you will not get my business. And there's no me going back and saying, can you do better? You get one chance, one price. You're either hired or fired. Do you understand? There's no going back to your manager. And you got to make that clear. So the cool thing is, after I've called 15 dealerships, I'll probably get 10 emails. Some of them are just so dopey, they're not going to email you back. But you'll get 10. And then out of those 10, you take the top offer. Now, I found that to work exceedingly well, because here's the last time we bought Mama a Nissan. I remember talking to the person, and I said, I just wanted to tell you that I'm firing you. You were not the successful bidder. And they said, do you mind me asking what was the successful bid? I said, yeah, the successful bid was X. And it made me feel so good, I almost cried. They said, sir, I don't know how they're selling it to you at that price. I could not beat that price. You got a wonderful deal. And we've done that for the last, I don't know, 3 or 4. So that's my method of buying a new car. And it works wonderfully. But you got to put yourself in control. You got to be the alpha going in there and say, well, you're not going back to your little manager. You don't get a net, you know, can I do something to get your business? No. Can I go check my manager? No. You get one shot. And it works beautifully. Oh, does it work beautifully? But again, I don't think anybody ought to be buying new cars. But my mom wants to buy a new car, and I love it when she does, because she gives me her old one. I just keep driving it and driving it and driving it until it won't drive no more. All right, that was good. All right, any questions about anything we're doing today? Y'all even found out how to buy cars? I think I'm feeling a little bit better too, so I'm not going to be chucking all over the place. Any questions at all? Anything? Going one, going twice. All righty, then I'll see y'all tomorrow. Don't forget, tomorrow is at 2:00, okay? Y'all have a great, great day, and I'll see you tomorrow.